Seth Rollins, formerly known as Tyler Black.
Moonsault by Tyler Black connects.
Gix. Taj the Destroyer, God, and Colby Lopez.
One, two, three, ding, ding.
We are en route to Don's Pub out in Donahue, Iowa, and this was the place where I basically had my first half-trained wrestling match, if you will. And subsequent matches after. This was the first place that, you know, my little independent company around here and me and my friends that were doing that when we were 17, 18 years old, this was our first home. We don't really get an opportunity to stop and smell the roses very much, so this is kind of a way to do that, you know, to come back and reminisce a little bit about what it was like to start being Seth Rollins, I guess. And it's cool, you know, you go from Monday Night Raw in a marquee matchup last night to coming back to Don's Pub in Donahue, Iowa the next day. If you look that way, you look that way, it's the entire town. That's the whole thing, one street, there's nothing. And it looks exactly the same, smells exactly the same. One of those places that kind of never changes. It'll be interesting to see what the inside looks like, I'm sure. Probably exactly the same as well. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is the spot. This was our locker room. This was it. This is the room. This is where the magic happened, guys. Set the ring up right in the middle. Now these tables out of the way, obviously. Set the chairs up. That's the spot. This is it. I had so many of my first shows in this space right here. This is where I honed my craft, if you will, you know? And we had black curtains, and there was a full entrance kind of, it was built out of wood, handmade by some of the guys. And you bust through the curtain and you, you know, however you feel. And it's funny because it makes you feel small in a sense. You know, you almost don't want to get outside your shell, but to like suck in that small crowd and have them invest in the match, you have to act like it's the most important thing in the world. It prepared me for almost every experience I've ever had in a wrestling ring. Finding a persona is a difficult thing to do, you know? Shuffled through a few in the beginning, you know? First night I ever wrestled, I went by Gix, G-I-X-X, which is a name of a character in Magic the Gathering, and I was never a big Magic guy. I mean, that was my brother's thing, but he had the name and he thought it was cool and gave it to me, and I was like, yeah, it's cool. So it wasn't cool. Not really a very chantable name either. Even in that stretch before I found my next name, I used a character named Taj the Destroyer, which was just a one-off, also not cool. Eventually, I got trained, and my trainer, Danny Daniels, was very, very adamant that I get a real name. Yeah, Danny forced me into Tyler Black, which is what I ended up landing on for the majority of my independent career.
Danny Daniels actually trained Tyler Black and Merrick Brave, teacher versus student right now.
Kind of snatched it up from a couple of characters that I liked, Tyler Durden, Fight Club, and Sirius Black and Harry Potter. So it kind of merged those worlds. I never had like a major character. I was never a character guy. I wasn't like a Bray Wyatt or an Undertaker. I was just me, you know, I just came through the curtain and tried to win the fans over, you know, in the ring.
Tyler Black!
Somersault plancha!
And the crowd erupts here at the Berwyn Eagles Club.
And I was Tyler Black for 6 years. 6 years till I got to WWE, signed with them, and down in FCW, they said, say goodbye to Tyler Black and let's figure out something new. And between myself and you know, the late great American Dream Dusty Rhodes, we came up with Seth Rollins.
My name is Seth Rollins.
and I have come to Florida Championship Wrestling to change everything you think you know about me, about you, and about sports entertainment. The time to move is now.
My transformation from Gix to Seth Rollins would have never happened without dabbling in wrestling with my friends during my teenage years. The only difference was I believed it wasn't just a side hobby, but that it could have been potentially the start of a career.
I always just had it in my head that if I worked harder than everybody else, I would get the opportunity to do all the things I wanted to do. But for me, I put all my eggs in one basket. I never looked any other direction. And maybe that, you know, mentally, maybe that was part of it that helped me get where I wanted to go. But I never thought to myself, I can't do this. This is it, folks. This is where it started for me. This was the site of my first WWE live event. Remember my dad and my uncle brought myself and my brother here. I was probably 4, 5 years old at the most, 5 probably. The show itself changed my life. I mean, realistically, from that point on, I looked at the WWE superstars as superheroes. It's crazy what one experience can do in sort of changing the course of, you know, where you're gonna be in your life when you grow up. For a little kid, 4 years old, just from a small town in Iowa, I mean, at this point in my life, I literally lived in a town of 1,000 people, you know? So to me, this was it. This was my view. I remember when my dad was yelling, he was like, way out, leaned out over here. And I thought he was gonna fall. I was like, I legit thought he was gonna fall down. It's crazy. When I see little kids, you know, with my t-shirt on or my wristbands or, you know, holding signs, it's crazy to think that they feel the same way about me that I felt about, you know, Hulk Hogan. So that's pretty wild to think of, that you can have that sort of impact on another human's life. I didn't think coming here would really dredge up that much information or memories for me, but it has for whatever reason. You know, it's like the origin story. The origin story of Seth Rollins. I think I took pieces of every character that I ever had or every persona that I ever had, obviously into the next one, but I think there are always remnants of Gix and Seth Rollins. You know, even Taj the Destroyer somewhere, there's a little bit in there. As much as I've changed, as much as I've evolved over the years in my career, I think I'm still the same kid that I was, you know, when I was 16 years old, 14 years old, maybe even 4 years old, you know, watching my first live event. So there are pieces of all that in who I am today.